So this is my Synology NAS. It's a model DS1618+. I think back in 2018, I migrated over to this TVMosaic PVR TV tuner software. I had been using the prior version of this called DVBLogic, and they had come up with this new version of their software called TVMosaic in 2018. And so when I got the new NAS, I went ahead and purchased a license to the TVMosaic package and installed that, and had been running that as a native application on DSM 6.2. That's the disk station manager. That was working very well, but then around 2020, DVBLogic went out of business. There was some sort of a thing going around in 2020, and apparently that was the end of their business operations. But they did release what they call a community edition. So it's called TVMosaic CE, and they released that on GitHub or GitLab, whatever the link is there. They have all of their old versions. So they have the Synology native version, Windows, Raspberry Pi. They also released a Docker version that you can install under Docker as a container. So at that point, I guess I had to swap over to the community edition because the licensed version that I was running, I couldn't verify the license, or there was something with the licensing. And I think that's because they maybe shut down their licensing server page or whatever. So I switched over to the CE edition, and yeah, that works just fine. I've been running that since 2020. But what happened in the meantime is Synology released DSM 7, the new update of their Disk Station Manager software, and that requires new applications that are built for DSM 7. And because DVBLogic was no longer updating this software, it no longer was compatible with DSM 7 as a native application. So the fix, though, was that you could download and install the Docker version and run TVMosaic under Docker. So I tried to do that. There was a number of web pages I found. Here's one, they're talking about TVMosaic on DSM 7.0. Yeah, so like I say, I was looking through here. There's a couple of posts down here, several years old, where they're giving various Docker command lines to get this thing running. This one here is so that you can run the non-CE version. I'm not sure if that would work or not, but I'm running the CE version. Here's a little more detailed walkthrough. I tried doing this one here. You've got all of these fill in the blank, put your old location, put your thing here. I tried following some of these and I couldn't get any of these to completely work. I did get it to partially work. This is the Synology Docker UI or GUI that they provide. So I have this TVMosaic container running here, and I was able to get the ports set. So if you just set the local port and the container port all the same, that way these show up on your NAS IP address. So it looks like this application or container is running on the same network as the NAS. And then here's the volume assignments. Yeah, so before you can install Docker, what you need to do is come in here to your Docker folder here, and then you create this TVMosaic folder. That's where your configuration data will be stored. And then you create this TVMosaic underscore recordings folder. That's where your recorded TV files end up. And then here's my original TVMosaic folder under volume 1/TVMosaic. And then inside of there, there's my recorded TV folder. and then all of the configuration, channel logos, all that stuff is in there. You create that, and then you could come into the GUI here, and you could assign that folder there, Docker TVMosaic, to the original mount path. Same with the recorded TV. You also had all of the environment variables that all got picked up, at least up to this point, these four. This was something I got to show up later. I'll show you how I did that. Under network, you have two options with Docker. You have the bridge network and you have the host network. So the host network says use the IP address of the host server, the Synology NAS, and that's this address. But I could not get that to select. The host network was grayed out. The only thing I could select was the bridge network, and the bridge network is 172.17.0.0. So the idea is all the Docker containers live in that virtual network and can talk to each other, and then they go through these ports. So the local port on that 172.17 network connects to the port on the Synology NAS, and there's no port contention here. These are all unique port identifiers, so I didn't have to worry about any port collisions, so to speak. You know, these all work separately. But like I said, I could not get host to select. And what would happen is, so I could get this to come up, and I could come over here to channels, and what I run is some HD home run TV tuners. So these are network TV tuners. I could get this and this to show up from my old configuration, but I could not get the actual tuners to show up. And if I went in here and ran a channel scan, it would go through the whole scan and find zero channels, because these tuners are on my local network that the NAS is on. They're not on 172.17.0. something. And I think that's what the thing does, is it just goes out on the local subnet and pulls all the IP addresses on the local subnet and says, oh, here's a couple of tuners. Do you want me to use them? Well, it couldn't find any tuners, and it couldn't connect to any of them. So I was stuck here. I could get to this point, but there were no channels to tune. There was no settings I could set, because you don't actually go in here and select these tuners. They show up when you perform a scan, but I would perform a scan and there were no tuners found. Anyway, I went over and I found this page. It's a German web page. The Google Translate, or whichever translate I'm running here, works really well on this page. So just translate it to whatever your language is. And it talks about, here's how to set up Docker TV Mosaic on a Synology NAS. This was, again, about a little over 3 years old, and he kind of goes through some of that history. He's talking about setting up the community edition. What he mentions is that he's using TV Mosaic with IPTV, and what he found was he needed to run TV Mosaic on his Synology host network. So he was running off in this virtual network and not on the Synology network. And he said it did not work because there were problems retrieving the stream in the container. And I bet you that's the same problem I had trying to get to the network TV tuners in the container. So he said what he did was he got this working in Synology using Portainer-CE. So I was not running Portainer. I'd heard of it. It's a Docker container that you can run other Docker containers under. And it's sort of a manager of Docker containers. You can do the Docker command line. You can do Docker compose, Portainer. And you've got the Synology user interface. So there's many ways you can run Docker. But I like this one because he pretty much spelled out what you had to do. So to install Portainer, I went to this page here on wondertech.net, and he had a really straightforward way to install Portainer on a Synology NAS. Again, this is about 3.5 years old, and it was written for DSM 6.2, but it still works. I have to create this Portainer-CE folder. I think he talks about that here. Open file station, you create Portainer-CE, then you SSH into your NAS, and you run that command. At that point, you just log into your NAS with port 9000, and that is this here. So I got Portainer running, following his directions, and yeah, that came right up, no problem at all. And then what you do is you come into your local configuration, I guess, I don't know what it's called here, but what I found you had to do was go to stacks. But I have a stack here, and that's where I got to this one. This is what this guy was talking about here. Now, he had it running under containers. I wasn't able to get it running until I did stack. But then he has this whole file. You just copy and paste this thing, but you've got to delete all these comments. So this is a Docker compose file. So this is assuming you were running TVMosaic as a native application so that you've got this already. And the key, I think, is that if you put this right here, this network mode host, and you do it under the stacks setting, it allows you to go to hosts as the network. Here's the Synology UI. If you look on network, it says host, and then here's this server IP that came in, and the virtual host, and I don't have the web password set right now. I don't have this exposed outside of my local network. But there, everything shows up. You get the TV tuners, and you can come over here to like TV guide, and you can click on a TV show.
Of course. Thanks for the tea, Thelma.
So, yeah, everything works. So like I said, I had to do it under stacks versus containers. Under stack, so I created this TV mosaic, and this was the only place I could get this to paste in here. So this is that compose file that was on that German website, and then I've just changed the local IP addresses for my local network. And you can see I got rid of all the comments. And once I pasted this in and hit start, it just came up running. Like I say, I don't know if this is totally required. I just couldn't find where to paste that compose file into the container page. Versus under stacks, it was right there. I could just go to editor and paste it in. So yeah, the one big thing I like about the TV Mosaic, number one, is it has built-in XML TV program guide support, and I get that through Perk Data. So I subscribe to the Perk Data, and they give you a command line that you run with your user ID and login, and I think once a day the TV Mosaic server goes out, pulls down the next couple of days worth of program guide, and then does all the parsing and gets it into the right format. And so the thing I like is that I can come in here and assign a particular channel to a particular program guide entry, because sometimes I find these are not correct, but I can change that manually, and then that propagates to all of my Kodi viewers or clients. The other thing I like with TV Mosaic is it also has transcoding. Now my NAS does not have a hardware transcoding feature. The CPU I have in mine doesn't have any built-in GPU functionality, but it's got four CPU cores. Generally one of them is involved running the Synology DSM, I have one running Home Assistant, but that leaves me two free cores, and one of them can run software transcoding, and that one CPU is plenty, and I can run transcoding out to my garage playback unit, and I have to run transcoding there, number one, because I've got a lower res screen out there, and number two, I'm running on a pretty long Wi-Fi connection, and I don't have like 100 megabit connection. I have like 5 megabit or 2 megabit connection out there, so I need to transcode the signal down to like 640 by 480 to get the bandwidth down. And this works fine for what I need to do. And if I ever open this up for external playback, like with my phone, I could also do the transcoding to handle, you know, low bandwidth conditions. One CPU core can do all the transcoding I need for any low bandwidth operation. I don't know if I could do HD transcoding at real time, but I don't need to do that. If I'm on my local network, I usually have gigabit network speed, so I don't have to do any transcoding. But yeah, that's how you can get TVMosaic running under Docker on Synology DSM. Right now I'm running 7.1. I need to ultimately upgrade to 7.2, but I wanted to get this working first, just so I had my local TV tuner support again. Anyway, that is TVMosaic. The nice thing is this community edition is available on the GitLab site. You don't need a license for it. It works really well. I haven't really found any bugs with it. This was updated, I believe, about 3 years ago, and it still seems to work. The only thing that I see might be an issue is if ATSC 3.0 becomes more popular. I'm not sure if TVMosaic will handle that. I don't have any ATSC 3 tuners, so it's not a big deal for me. I don't think we have many. There might be one or two stations locally that broadcast an ATSC 3 signal, but I haven't purchased a tuner yet until they get rid of ATSC 1 and you have to upgrade. I'm probably not going to upgrade because I don't watch that much TV, maybe 15 minutes catching the news in the morning. Yeah, it just comes up running. It picks up all your old configuration. All the old settings are there, the program guide. So anyway, hope you found that helpful. And if you did, give the video a thumbs up. And as always, thanks for watching.